So, hello everyone. I'm Anja Polajnar from Ljubljana, Slovenia. I'm working for Jozef Stefan Institute, and I'm also part of the organizing team of Open Education for Better World Mentoring Program. First, I would like to give a short introduction, and then our colleagues, Dr. Baviskar Chandrakant, Sandeep Patil, and Reka Chavan, prepared an analysis on prospects of the program. So first, Open Education for a Better World is an international mentoring program supporting development and implementation of freely accessible modules and resources for online education on topics with social impact, according to the UN Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs. It provides innovative approach to building OER, connecting developers of educational materials with internationally recognized experts volunteering as mentors. In 3 years, we developed 131 projects, which have been included with 100 mentors being involved into the program in the last 3 years. So how everything started? The program was established in 2017 after the Second World Congress on OER held in Ljubljana, Slovenia. The program was established and is managed by Professor Tanja Urbančič from University of Nova Gorica and Mitja Ermol, UNESCO Chair on Open Technologies for OER and Open Learning at Jozef Stefan Institute. So let's see how it works. There is a call every autumn, every October, for developers and for mentors. Then, in the end of November, we pair them based on OER maturity, content, and the geographical proximity. In January, the work starts and developers work together with mentors. They meet on weekly or bi-weekly meetings. Then there are regular chat points with hub coordinators and with initiators. And then the program concludes in the final event, usually in the beginning of July, in the premises of University of Nova Gorica in Vipava. So let us see the situation in 2018. There were 14 developers from all over the world. We had a nice event in Vipava in a beautiful Lantieri mansion. So we managed this by ourselves, the Open Education for Better World initiators and myself. Then in 2019, we had 35 developers from all over the world. And because we wanted to maintain the same quality of the organization, we introduced hubs, regional hubs and hub coordinators. And we are very thankful. We cooperated with Professor Vasuda Kama, Dr. Jayashri Shinde, who manage Hub Asia, Dr. Jenny Hyman, who managed Hub America. At that time, she covered North and South America, and Igor Lesko, who managed Hub Europe and Africa. We also had a nice event in Vipava, Slovenia. This time more people, it was packed with presentations, workshops, keynote speeches, and so on. Let's see the program in 2020, 82 developers. So this is why we had to introduce more hubs. All hub coordinators stayed with us, but also new joined. Dr. Tela Miel and Werner Westermann managed hub South America. Naomi Valls managed hub Europe. Mojca Drevenšek and Janvin Wetzler managed Hub SDG 7, focusing on sustainable energy. And this was the first topical hub we had. So we are very thankful to our hub coordinators. Without them, our work would not be possible. And in 2020, we of course had an online meeting. It was held in Open Education for Better World platform powered by Meetim. We had a 4-day event packed with keynote speeches, project pitches, Open Education Festival with highlight of open education in Asia and so on. So it was a nice event. And now 20, in the next year, we are welcoming everyone who would like to join us. The applications are still open. They will be open until 30th of November, so some days still left. Please join us. This is the link to join us. Thank you, everyone. This is a joint effort by everyone, developers, mentors, hub coordinators. We are grateful to you. Once again, I'm thankful to Tanya Urbancic and Mitter Moore for involving me in this program. Thankful to Anna Fabian for this wonderful presentation. And thank you, Open Education Global organizers, for this amazing event. Thank you for hosting us.
Okay. Hello, everyone. This is Sandeep Patil. We have undertaken this study on UNESCO's OE4BW online mentoring program, and we have tried to analyze its impact and its prospects. As Anya has already mentioned, the purpose and the scope of this OE4BW program, I won't be expanding or deliberating upon it. But it is the program, or it is an initiative which is dedicated towards the promotion of open education and attainment of sustainable developmental goals through designing, developing, and deploying quality OERs, and year by year, gradually, the community is expanding and the quality OERs are being developed and deployed. The aim of our study was to understand the contribution and prospects of OE4BW program towards promotion of open education and realization of sustainable development goals. The data was collected from coordinators and the MOOC or UNESCO OE4BW OER MOOC beneficiaries who were benefited from those MOOCs developed under this OE4BW program. Tools were opinionaire for hub coordinators, mentors, and developers, as well as one learner satisfaction survey was also used to collect the data. And the results are there, which are really encouraging. They reflect that the global collaboration for developing OERs is either strongly promoted or promoted, and all majority of the hub coordinators, mentors, and developers, they agree that this program promotes global collaboration. Same is the case regarding the promotion of open education, that the hub coordinators, mentors, and developers do think that this program supports and promotes open education. It empowers the people for OER development, is the consent of all the hub coordinators, mentors, and developers by large. Does this program significantly address the SDGs? Well, on a high side, we can say, on a high scale, we can say, majority of the community members of this program think that SDGs are supported. As the purpose of joining this program being served, well, all the hub coordinators think like that. Majority of the mentors are also of that opinion that the purpose of joining this program has been served. And the developers are also, majority of the developers do think that the purpose is served. Well, thinking about the developer, mentor, and hub coordination collaboration, majority of the community members are really excited and pleased about this type of collaboration, which is very unique one in terms of any global event. It is a very unique sort of collaboration that has been used for this OE4BW program. Significance of this program, majority of the members do think that the global collaboration, OER development, as well as providing the training are the areas where the significance of this program is being highlighted. OE4BW, when I think about the OE4BW as a learner, the beneficiaries of these various OER MOOCs developed under this program, their remarks were really pleasing to all of us as OE4BW members. They really were helped by these sort of MOOCs developed under this program. Their satisfaction levels were also high. They think that the technology used for this program was really advanced as well as user friendly. They were satisfied regarding the attainment of the learning outcomes of these MOOCs. They were really satisfied with the learner interactivity that was there throughout that MOOC, and as well as the learner centricity was also towards the higher side when it comes towards these MOOCs. So learner centricity was there, learner interactivity was highly promoted, as well as the satisfaction levels of the learners from these MOOCs was really a pleasing thing. Then there are some graphs which show that the learners are also of the opinion, majority of the learners are also of the opinion that these MOOCs or these OERs promote open education, they address sustainable development goals, they also are motivating the learners to use OER prominently in their teaching learning process, as well as they were really satisfied, majority of them were really satisfied with the quality of the expertise of the developers, and they themselves, majority of them, they themselves think that they would like to join UNESCO OE4BW program as a developer in the future also. So what is the scope for improvement? See, nothing is perfect in the world and there is always a scope for improvement. And though this program is moving towards a positive path of improvement, but there are still some improvements to be done. First of all, the time frame of the program can be improved, which is the concern. The advisory body will definitely look after it. The interaction between hub coordinators, mentors, and developers can be groomed in a better manner and through more intensified communications, as well as the follow-up of the project can be an area of improvement. Then the developer accountability can be definitely. Improved. My personal opinion is also developers and mentors are definitely advising for, definitely suggesting for. Then there should be a feedback mechanism that can be of more significance. See, the prospects of this program, really there was wonderful responses from the various community members regarding the prospects of this program. It can be regarding the reaching out to different stakeholders at different levels. We are expanding by size, but different levels of stakeholders can be also accommodated in this program. Also, collaborations with various national, international NGOs and institutions can be a part of the prospects for this program. Building national and regional hubs is one of the very welcoming prospect that was mentioned by one of the respondent. Also, building a large community of open education, that is really a thing that is going on. The expansion is there, right? Entering into, and definitely the community is expanding day by day. OER hosting platform, it is a very, very important need that all of us are demanding from OE4BW, that it should have its own platform, as well as authentic publication of the content is one of the area where OE4BW can work upon. Also, financing and validation of the projects, that is an area of development, regarding the courses can be created under OE4BW, which will have the authenticity as well as some credit for them that can be used as a supportive career-based system. Along with it, some curricula can be developed, generate the moment of empowering the teachers and building upon the community of OE4BW developers and promoters. The community building is one of the areas that can be groomed day by day, and the expansion will go on and on year after year. And overall, the prospect of this OE4BW by large will be improving the quality of education by providing quality OERs, bringing and empowering the educators for use of OER, development of OERs, and developing sustainable open education models. These are the things that are, that show that the prospect of this program is a very large one. And we all, as the members of this community, can work for it. And I think we are really pleased to be associated with this program. And as Anya has suggested in her presentation, I also appeal to all of the viewers to please have your thinking about this program, and you can apply for this for the year 2021. That's all I have from my side. It was a very rapid presentation because of the time constraint, and thank you.